In this demonstration, we're going to focus on data center and private cloud management, specifically focused on hybrid deployment with System Center 2012 SP1. Now, Microsoft System Center 2012 offers unique application management capabilities that can empower you to deliver agile, predictable application services to your business counterparts. System Center 2012 enables the concept of application as a service, where a service is a deployed instance of a cloud-style application along with its associated configuration and virtual infrastructure. One key technology in System Center 2012 SP1 is App Controller. Now, App Controller provides a common self-service experience that can help you easily configure, deploy, and manage virtual machines and services across private and public clouds. Now, let's take a deeper look at this technology and how you can use it in your environment today. Now, here we're showing System Center 2012 SP1 App Controller, which is an integrated experience for managing all my clouds, both private and public, on-premises and off. Best of all, I can use this tool to deploy new cloud infrastructure no matter where that cloud is. Now let's deploy a new web VM to Windows Azure so we can take advantage of its ability to scale as fast as my business needs. Now the first thing I need to do is select a deployment type. Azure not only supports VMs, I can also deploy cloud services and even virtual disks all from my single console. In this case, I'm going to deploy a brand new image and configure this to be part of my web front end for a financial application. For this, I have pre-created a financial service to house my VMs and resources. So from the catalog of images provided to me from Azure, I'm going to select the best platform for web applications available, Windows Server 2012. Now, as I mentioned earlier, we pre-configured a service to assign this new virtual machine to. To continue, I just simply click Configure under Cloud Service, actually choose that pre-configured service. Now instantly, I can see all the resources of this service and which VMs are allocated to it. Now to add an additional VM, next I have to define the settings for the VM itself. Again, I hit Configure under Virtual Machine. I simply name the virtual machine. Azure also provides me multiple choices of VM capacity, from extra small to extra large, like when I buy a t-shirt. I choose the exact one that fits my needs, and for our needs, we're going to keep the default as medium. Next, we're going to define the storage for our VM. Now, we've got a number of options here, also enabling us to finely tune this VM and the cloud service for our exact needs. In this case, I've pre-created a storage unit for my new web application. Lastly, I'm just going to add a new administrator password for this VM. And click OK to save the settings. And now my VM configuration is complete. Now you could see that I have many other controls as needed, such as virtual networks and even the ability to join my domain as part of the setup, all making it easy to expand my capacity utilizing Azure. Now everything is completed, I simply hit the deploy button and sit back. Just like that, Windows Azure is now creating the VM to our requirements. Now let's click over to virtual machines and see how our virtual machine provisioning is happening. And there we go, in a few small clicks, I'm now provisioning a new virtual machine in Windows Azure utilizing System Center 2012 SP1 App Controller. So you can see a really powerful demonstration on how we can now have our data center without boundaries and deploy VMs in private clouds, service providers, and even Windows Azure, and also have a single view of them in System Center 2012 SP1. Thank you.